Welcome everybody to College Night. I'm Shoni Francis.
And I'm Randy Russo.
And tonight we'll be serving you up a special treat.
Yes, since it is the holiday season, we've decided that we're going to spice things up in the kitchen as well as see what's cooking on the entertainment scene.
And no, we won't be cooking you up ramen noodles.
No, but
I'm going to be making some cornbread. My special own kind of cornbread.
And I was thinking about doing a turkey, but I figured that the mamas can take care of that portion. And I'll be doing my favorite meal, the dessert. I'll be doing a banana split cake. So Shoni, what kind of ingredients do you think we're going to need for the cornbread?
Okay, first of all, you need your Jiffy cornbread.
Okay, Jiffy cornbread mix.
All right. Okay. Then you need your milk.
We've got milk too, I think. Milk.
All right, then you need your butter.
Got butter.
And you need your eggs.
All right, how many eggs do we need? Not the whole thing.
I'm not sure, but I'll check. The instructions are on here.
So. Yeah, this is his special cornbread. Yeah, his extra special cornbread, the Jiffy cornbread.
You need one egg.
One egg. All right, we got one egg. All right, while you guys are gathering up these ingredients at your houses, Shoni's going to spotlight some albums for us.
Well, I'm going to spotlight some albums that I picked up. You may have picked them up, you may not, but I'm going to give you my 5-star rating on them. Shoni's 5-star rating. But the first album I picked up was Fabulous's Real Talk. Now this album, this is his third album. You know, he didn't experience a sophomore jinx, but on his third album, I give it about a 3.5 stars out of 5 because he's not talking about his jewels and what he has, his cars, his flunk. He's more concentrating on his lyrics and the content of his music. And the second album that I picked up was Snoop Dogg. You know, everybody loved the big Snoop Dogg, the big D-O double jizzle. You know, this is his album called Rhythm and Gangsta. Out of 5 stars, I give him about a 3.5 stars because, it's Snoop. I mean, everybody loves Snoop. You know, he has some guest appearances by 50 Cent, Pharrell, the Bee Gees, and Bootsy Collins. So if you're into that, you know, get Snoop. It's a great album that you like to chill. The next album that I picked up was R. Kelly's and Jay-Z's Unfinished Business. They do have some unfinished business to settle, but, you know, no matter what legal problems is going on with them, you know, they still know how to come together and collaborate and make music. And the fourth album that I picked up was Sierra Goodies. Everybody know who Sierra is. You know, she has the one with the goodies, a hot single. She also has another single, 1-2 Step. So out of 5 stars, I give Sierra a 3. You know, she deserves it. I mean, she's an upcoming artist. So everybody, you know, go pick up these CDs if you have a chance. My 3 rating, I'm just a hard rater, but a 3 is good in my book. So go and pick up these CDs if you have a chance.
All right, Shoni, thank you for that review. Now let's get back to the food. How do you make your cornbread?
All right, first you need your Jiffy mix.
Yeah, you need that. Got your ingredients and how you cook it.
Just pour it in there like that.
All right.
Then you need your milk.
How much milk do I need? I think you need to put the whole thing in there.
You need to put the whole... Yeah. Well, just go ahead and put it in. I mean, hey, women know how to cook. I don't know how to cook. All then right. You put your milk in there.
Okay.
There's your milk, okay. And also your egg. Let me go ahead and do that egg.
Put the egg in there.
There's your egg. And now your butter.
Okay.
You put your butter in here. I need my knife to cut it. Folks, if y'all just tune in, this is not a cooking show. This is still College Night. We just have a special treat, like I said before.
All right, while Shoni takes care of this, we had a chance to check out the Greek show in October, see them strutting their stuff, along with special correspondent April Thomas from KSLU.
Big shout out to April.
Yeah, let's check it out.
There was a great turnout at the University Center for the 22nd annual Greek show for the Kappa Nu chapter of Alpha Phi Alpha. This event is an annual step show that is put on for fraternities and sororities at Southeastern University to compete for a prize of $3,000. It marked the first time that an event of this type had been held in the University Center. Due to the overflowing crowd last year, the Greek show was moved from the Potter Auditorium.
Well, basically, it's for all the African-American fraternities and sororities come out and compete in what we call stepping. It goes back from the early 1900s from which we was founded. And we just come out here and compete and show the campus and people around in the region what they have to offer.
All of the sororities and fraternities put on an excellent show. The sororities included Delta Sigma Theta of Southern Mississippi, Alpha Kappa Alpha of LSU, and Sigma Gamma Rho of Southeastern. The fraternities included the Alpha Phi Alphas of ULL, the Omega Psi Phi of LSU, Phi Beta Sigmas of Southern Mississippi, and the Alpha Phi Alphas of LSU.
For the different universities to get together so that they can do a little networking. If nothing else, at least they can make some new friends. But I think it's a good thing. I think that at least they have something to build on now. So hopefully they get bigger and better. Hopefully they start doing it every semester rather than waiting once a year, but that'd be nice.
Bigger and better. They got the Kappa Nu chapter of Alpha Phi Alpha, which had over 2,000 people in attendance with a prize worth $5,000. Christina Cherie of 94.9 and Tony King of Max 94.1 were special hosts for the Greek show.
Are y'all ready to find out who the winners of tonight's step show?
Woo! Come on.
With a grand total of 369 points. Make some noise for the ladies of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated. Give it up for the men who brought the real African to the stage.
Come on, you got to, you got to.
The men of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated from the University of Southern Mississippi.
Okay, a Southern Mississippi sweep. It was for the men of Phi Beta Sigma and the women of Delta Sigma Theta. In the sororities and fraternities division, little did they know they were competing against each other for an additional $2,000. The Sigmas were the biggest winners in the competition with a total purse of $3,000. They had a show-stopping performance and original routine. The 22nd annual Kappa Nu Alpha Phi Alpha Greek show was a huge success. It wasn't only about stepping, singing, and dancing, or about the biggest purse in the state for a Greek show. This event was about making history, bringing people together to witness the largest Greek show ever on Southeastern's campus.
The Greek atmosphere here I found to be very nurturing. They accepted me, they welcomed me, they invited me to a lot of different events here on campus.
Okay guys, it's time to see how Shoni's special cornbread turned out.
I know my cornbread is gonna be good.
All right, let's see.
I know it's gonna be good.
Well, and then with TV magic, wow, it's got a little top one and everything,
Shoni. Thank you, hooray for Shoni, hooray.
All right, let's just see how it tastes with all that milk.
Hey, where did we get that silver bowl from? I thought we had a bowl.
We put it in the thing, cut it. Smells good, smells decent.
Do you want to try my cornbread after I mixed it?
No, that's okay. I think we'd like to check out the Better Than Ezra special. We have the second episode of our special.
You need some more milk, bro.
Lord. And all I got to say, yeah, is your love's extraordinary. How did bringing the audience members on stage to play a song with y'all, how did that get started, and are there any requirements?
We always try to do something where we bring the audience in. For a long time we did, for a while I had this Dr. Sample. It's this little thing that Roland, a company, an electronics company makes. We might, it was a little sampler, a handheld sampler, and I attached a wireless device to it, and I would go out into the audience, and you know, I'd press a button, and people would say their names, and then I would work it in rhythmically to a song, and that was very popular. And then we like, okay, we got to change that; it's getting old. Then we had a dance contest, which may have been ill-advised from the get-go.
Oh, but made some for some funny nights.
But there were some amazing nights, and then we decided, you know, years ago, I think we'd all saw U2. I bring somebody up on stage to play Stand By Me, an old... Sam Cooke? No.
Benny King,
you're right. And as we just decided to take a nod from that. And so we bring people out on this time of year, and you know, the two requirements, you got to be able to play guitar, and you have to know the song. And I've gotten really, people like, how do you know the guy's not going to be full of it, or the girl's going to be full of it? And I'm like, you know, I've really gotten, I've been burned enough by people who were just nuts. I set the bar so high, so you got to do, meet these requirements, exceed these requirements, and you're going to be representing for Hammond, you know.
Right.
If you meet those requirements, raise your hand, it'll be always be somewhere like, you know, and then you get up there and like, okay, play, and they're just like, I don't know how to play. but it's happened enough to where I can turn it in, you know, turn it into something funny, and there's always somebody else who has their hand raised. But the point is, I've gotten really good at discerning if someone's the real deal or not. And when they are, it's just...
It can be amazing. And really that's fun. The beauty, though, is you really don't know what you're going to get.
Sometimes
you know?
It's good. And sometimes it's good when they're really bad.
That's what's just as entertaining to us as it is the audience, because nobody knows what's coming, you know. And we have had everything from horrible to you know, one guy came on, came on stage and was the best musician on the stage, you know. So, you know, so we've seen all variety of things.
It's interesting for sure. For sure.
How does it make y'all feel to have a greatest hits album out now?
We wanted to call it Best Of, honestly, because you know, some of them were hits, and then some of them are just, most of them are radio singles that did well. Then there's some that are just fan favorites, never released as singles. And, but Warner Brothers, you know, wants to
they
do
want
greatest. They wanted to call greatest hits.
We had a great title for it and everything.
Yeah.
Maybe they'll still let us. Maybe sneak it in.
We'll see. I don't know. But no, with minor. Reservations, we're thrilled about having the greatest hits because it's just a milestone in your career.
I think that little taste of, oh, does this mean we're getting older, is far outweighed by, look at this career we've had so far.
Yeah,
you know, to get
cool.
to the point of being able to put something like that out is amazing.
And also, because we'll always be playing, you know, and in all likelihood, you know, 10, 15 years from now, the only thing you'll probably be able to get is the greatest hits.
Mm-hmm, so
you know,
lasting.
Yeah, I mean, right. The greatest hits just stick around, you know, and they're always viable as far as labels thinking, as far as making them money, and so it's really good for us.
Your fans aren't the largest group, but they're the most dedicated, they're the most loyal, Ezraelites, as they call themselves. What do y'all have to say about that? How does that make y'all feel?
Well,
thank God.
We have to agree, you know.
They've certainly been there for us, whether our records have done well or some that haven't done as well. They've always shown up and continue to. And I mean, it's one of the main reasons why we can continue to make music, for sure. We tour
a lot. They sometimes they push us too, you know, like if we're doing this, if sometimes we'll just kind of get complacent and do the same set list.
That's true.
A lot, and they'll start complaining on the message board. We're like, yeah, you're
so
right.
So we change
we
it.
Need
up.
To get, we need to get off our fannies
or
our keister.
All right, guys, and we're still looking for the winner of our Better Than Ezra contest. So if you guys have any ideas on how Better Than Ezra got their name or you know what it means or anything, send your responses into www.selu.edu/TV.
Hello everyone, it's me again, your host Natalie Crump for this edition of Word on the Street. Today we're in the Union here at Southeastern Louisiana University asking Southeastern students what's hot and what's not in the film and music industry. So let's take a look at the results.
Right now I'm in my truck actually. I have the new 12 Stone CD in there.
12 Stone?
Yeah.
And who is that?
They're actually a band here close to Mandeville, where they're from.
Jigolator. Who sings Jigolator?
Sam I Am.
What is a Jigolator?
I have no idea, but that's what he sings.
Can you show me how to do the Jigolator?
He's showing.
Jig, 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 jig. So if we were to go to your CD player and press play right now, what will we hear?
I believe I have a mix CD and the song from a movie, Wild Horses.
That's the name of the movie?
No.
That's the name of the song?
Yeah.
G, 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 go, go, go. G, G. Thank you. That was beautiful. Okay, and what's the last movie that you all have seen at the theater?
Ray.
Shrek 2.
Shrek 2.
Spider-Man 2.
Spider-Man 2. Something that a lot of Southeastern students, what about you? What's the last movie you've gone to see?
I saw Ray.
You saw Ray? Is Ray good?
Yeah, good.
We've seen a lot of good reviews on Ray. What's the last movie that you've seen?
Uh,
Lamb? Yeah. The Bronx Gia. Hell. And Gia.
Gia. We just watched that movie, Gia.
What is Gia about?
It's horrible.
It's good. It's horrible. It's a true story, okay? It's got Angelina Jolie starring in it, right? She's the first supermodel of the 80s, and she gets addicted to heroin and ruins her life.
I saw Ray last weekend. It was great.
What's the name of it?
Ray.
Oh, did you like that? What was it about?
Definitely. It was about Ray Charles, and Jamie Foxx really did a good job in the movie.
All right, well, now it's my turn to spread a little bit of holiday cheer with my banana split cake. So I've got my ingredients coming here, Shoni, my handy-dandy helper. He's going to help me.
Men, but stay out the kitchen.
Yeah, and this is good for girls because, you know, you can make this thing, and it's no bake. Like, it's really easy to make, and you don't really even have to cook it. And your boyfriend will think that you're a whip in the kitchen. So, it's all good. All right, Shoni, this is what you need for your banana split cake. First of all, I need 1 stick of margarine butter, which we got this already here. It's kind of used margarine. Already. But it's margarine or butter, whichever one you want to use. Okay. All right, 2 1/3 cups of butter. We need 2 packets of cream cheese, whichever your preference. You can do low fat or you can do the good stuff. We also need one large thing of pineapples. Make sure that your juice is drained and everything. I need some cherries, nuts, and whipped cream.
Whipped cream. Mm. Oh, what you making again?
Banana split cake.
With pineapples?
With pineapples. You'll see what happens.
Hey, all right, you got it. Well, while she's gonna be making her banana split pineapple cake, we're gonna keep you entertained with some upcoming films by Preview Theater.
Supposedly, Cousteau and his cronies invented the idea of putting walkie-talkies into the helmet. But we made ours with a special rabbit ear on the top so we could pipe in some music.
The Belafonte, home to Team Zisu. Skilled crew of deep sea divers, adventurers, documentary filmmakers.
Action!
Led by internationally renowned oceanographer Captain Steve Zisu, expert on every aspect of marine life.
Swamp leeches, everybody! Check for swamp leeches. Nobody else got hit? I'm the only one? What's the deal?
But there remains one form of life about which Captain Zisu knows very little.
You're supposed to be my son, right?
I want you on Team Zisu.
The answer's yes.
Well, it's got to be. I'll order you a red cap and a Speedo.
Oh!
This will be Team Zisu's most ambitious adventure to date. I'm going to go on an overnight drunk, and in 10 days, I'm going to set out to find the shark that ate my friend and destroy it.
What would be the scientific purpose of killing it?
Revenge.
You must swear, legally swear, that you'll not kill that shark.
Split into 2 groups. I'll take Ned, Ogata, and Wolodarski.
Thanks. Thanks a lot for not picking me.
We're being led on an illegal suicide mission.
I'm gonna fight you, Steve.
You never say, I'm gonna fight you, Steve. You just smile and act natural, and then you sucker punch it.
Action.
Are you finding what you were looking for out here with me? I hope so. Quiet out there tonight. Can you hear the jack whale singing?
Beautiful. I wonder what they're saying.
Well, that was the sludge tanker over there, but there you go.
Mr. Constantine, I'd like to ask you a few questions. I know the circles you travel in, the occult, exorcisms.
I need to understand.
You don't want to know what's out there. Trust me on this.
What if I told you that God and the devil made a wager for the souls of all mankind?
I don't believe in the devil.
You should. He believes in you.
Close your eyes. And whatever happens, don't look. You see them. They see you.
Welcome to my life.
All right, Shannon, you ready for dessert?
Ready.
Okay, well, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make our pie crust. You wanna grab a 9x13-inch pan and preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Now, this is really the only thing that needs to be cooked while we're doing this. So, that's the only thing. All right, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna grab one stick of margarine that's melted, 2 cups of the graham cracker crumbs, and 1/3 cup of sugar, and you're just gonna whip it all together, put it in the pan, stick it in the oven, and while you eat my food, get out the cherries, Shoney.
Cherries, you gotta love them.
Anyway, and you're sticking it in the oven and leave it in there for about 5 minutes and then take it out. Now after you finish with that, we're going to make our filling. Well, this is the filling. You wanna get 2 cartons of the cream cheese that we had earlier with the sugar that we had earlier as well, and mix it all up together in this nice little concoction. And we're gonna put it on top of this. And while I'm getting a handle on this, let's talk about movies. I mean, what's a movie without, a good review? You know, we wanna know what we wanna see and what we don't wanna see.
Ain't this the same bowl that I used to make my cornbread in?
No, it's not.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, we wanna know what we do wanna see and what we don't wanna see while we're not in college life, right? Right. So we've got our very own Chris Brown, our movie critic, with Roll the Credits.
It's quite amazing and whimsical that a spirit so poetic, so energetic, and so diligently inspiring could be summed up into a 3-letter word. The film Ray is quite an accomplishment for director Taylor Hackford, who has also directed The Devil's Advocate, Dolores Claiborne, and Proof of Life. While his films in the past have been somewhat suspenseful and compelling, none reaches the emotional spine into which Ray taps. Personal demons plague Charles throughout the story, leading to his use of heroin. Charles also begins an onslaught of womanizing as his fame erupts. However, his addictions do not affect his music, but instead inspire it. He takes a stand in the civil rights movement by refusing to play for a segregated audience in Georgia after being told by an African-American college student, "You can do something about it." His adulthood is paralleled with his childhood, which is slightly overdone, but is effective in showing the demons that plague Charles. While Charles has his flaws as a human being, we're ushered into his ingenious musical universe, a world where R&B can be combined with gospel, African Americans can tell their stories of growing up in country songs, producers can only take a backseat in awe, and no creative suggestions can go wrong. One can only sit astonished in admiration at Jamie Foxx's performance as Charles. While his tics and mannerisms are not the most difficult to perform, Fox exhales the magical aura of Charles, while not forgetting to externally personify the demons, fears, and guilt he feels. Fox delivers a gripping, complex, and Oscar-worthy performance. The sound in the film is fantastically dubbed, while Jamie Foxx's lip-syncing is so perfect, it's impossible to tell it's not his voice. While Ray dismisses many details and limits its time span to only a short number of years, it succeeds on so many other levels. Ray is basically a coming-of-age story about a man who is told his whole life he is a cripple. After overcoming the limitation of being blind, heroin addiction and womanizing become his cripples to overcome. Ray is truly a story about life and adversity. It is a positive, charismatic explosion that takes the audience inside the mind of Charles through its powerful emotional scenes. It is a film that depicts what his life has meant to so many, and it proves no goal is unattainable and any obstacle can be overcome.
While Randy's over here making her banana split.
Banana split cake.
We're gonna spotlight a local filmmaker, Ashley Harrison, with her film, Lemon Parade.
Underneath my
says I'll tease you.
Guys, right now we just went ahead and put sliced bananas, the four sliced bananas, all over the top of your already pie filling and the crust and all that good stuff. Now we're just gonna put some pineapple, spread it all across. Shoni, if you don't stop eating my cherries, you don't have anything left on top of it.
So hear me?
Okay, Shoni, grab, go ahead and grab the whipped cream. Okay, whipped cream, and then you're just gonna top it with the whipped cream, just like that. Doesn't have to be beautiful or anything. Well, actually, it does, but you know, this is cheating. Smear it on the crust. And Shoni, why don't you go ahead and top us off with some cherries?
No, you can do that. You can put the cherries on.
Wow.
I'm not going to, you can, because I've been eating your cherries all today. You can put it on there.
Alrighty. Right there. And the cherries on top and the nuts. Just stick the nuts on there. More nuts than that, Shoni. Oh, Lord. Go ahead and eat your cornbread. Eat your cornbread.
You gonna eat your cornbread?
Well, guys, that'll do it for this episode of College Night. While Shoni sits here and stuffs his face, we hope you'll join us again next time. I'm Randy Russo, Shoni Francis.
I'm Shoni Francis. Thanks. Same bat time, same bat channel. Y'all.